Students, last time Okay, students, it's the revision of our last lecture, transitive verbs. All of you know I have told you and I've explained and we have done the exercises also that transitive verbs are such verbs which have an object after them. Okay, Ali threw a ball, I drew a beautiful picture, we cooked rice, okay, and I read a storybook. These are all storybook. Rice, ball, beautiful picture, these are all direct object, okay? And they are directly related to the subject and to the verb. The verb is followed by an object. So these are called the transitive verbs. Then we also did intransitive verbs. Intransitive verbs are such verbs which do not require an object, okay? You can say that these verbs do not require an object to complete their action. For example, I write. It is not mentioned, what do I write? I write. Okay, if I say I write a letter, it is telling ke what I am writing. I am writing a letter. So, letter is the direct object because it is actually telling ke what the subject is doing. If I say I'm writing in my room, there is also no direct object because it is saying that I'm writing where I'm writing in my room, but it is not telling what I am writing. She is reading on her sofa. Okay, it is not mentioned what she is reading. They are just saying that she is reading while sitting on her sofa, okay, like this. Birds fly. I walk on the road. It is not telling directly what actually it is, just used as a phrase. I walk on the road. He writes beautifully. Okay? Then I've told you verbs of incomplete predication. Students, you know about subject and predicate. Subject is what comes in the start of a sentence, or what are we talking about, or who is doing the action. Okay? Predicate is includes verb also. Whatever the subject is doing, including his or her action, that is known as a predicate. For example, if I say, Alia writes on the board. So Alia is subject, writes on the board is predicate. Now, as I have told you, intransitive verbs do not require an object to complete their action. Okay? So that is why they sometimes require a complement to convey their sense in the sentence, to convey their full meaning in a sentence. Okay? So intransitive verb, which requires a complement to convey its complete meaning in a sentence, is called verb of incomplete predication. Okay? So that is why intransitive verbs require some complement in order to convey their complete meaning, so that they can be understood by the reader. What do they mean? Okay? So, such intransitive verbs which require a complement to convey their meaning are known as verbs of incomplete predication. Okay? Complement, as I've told you, it is different from the object because it is telling about the subject, the person who is doing the action. Okay? For example, we colored the fence blue. He looks puzzled. Okay? So blue and puzzled are the complements. Now, direct object. We have also done its exercise, direct and indirect object, but it's just a revision because we have to finish our chapter today. So a direct object is directly related to a verb. It's not an object, it's to a word. A direct object is directly related to a word. Okay? The teacher explained the topic. What is the teacher explaining? The topic. So the topic is the direct object because it is directly related to the verb explain. I painted the doors. What did I paint? I painted the doors. So the doors, the direct object, because they're directly related to the verb painted. Okay? She wrote a letter to me. Now what actually she is writing is a direct object, a letter. To whom she is writing? To me. So me is the indirect object and a letter is the direct object. I made a beautiful picture for him. A beautiful picture is directly related to the verb made. So it is a direct object. And for whom I'm making? For him. So him is the indirect object. Okay. This, all of you know, okay, intransitive verbs, verbs with no object. Okay. Intransitive verbs, verbs which require an object. Please be very careful because when I'm going to ask you people, all of you have to tell me one by one, okay? Without creating any disturbance. Okay, the new thing which I'm going to start. Objective complements. Obviously, objective means related to the object. Subjective means related to the subject, okay? Objective complements are required by the transitive verbs, not the intransitive verbs. You have to be very clear that subjective complements are required by the intransitive verbs and objective complements are required by the transitive verbs. Why? Because transitive verbs are verbs which are followed by an object, and intransitive verbs are verbs followed by an object. So that is why intransitive verbs require subjective complements and transitive verbs require objective complements. So please be very careful in the difference. The complements of transitive verbs tell us something important about the object, because all of you know that transitive verbs are such verbs which have an object after them. Therefore, they are called objective complements. They can be noun, adjective, or an adverb. My gift made her very excited. Her mother named her Sanya. The noun Sanya and adjective happy are called the complements of transitive verbs. My gift made her, direct object her. Her mother named her, her. Okay, direct object. Excited is used as an adjective, and Sanya, all of you know, is a noun. Okay, so objective complements can be a noun, adjective, or an adverb. Now, all of you know that subjective complements are required by intransitive verbs to complete their meaning, and transitive verbs sometimes require a complement to tell more about its object. These are known as objective complements. They can be a noun or an adjective. Okay. Now, transitive verb of incomplete predication, as I have explained to you, transitive verbs which require objective complements to convey their full meaning in a sentence are called transitive verbs of incomplete predication. Remember one thing. If a complement is required, they are known as incomplete predication. And if the complement is not required, they are known as complete predication. The reason? Because when we are saying transitive verbs of incomplete predication, why they are requiring complement? To convey their complete meaning. It means that their meaning is not complete. That is why they are known as incomplete predication. And if their meaning is complete, then they do not require any complement, because their meaning is already complete. I repeat again that transitive verbs which require a complement to convey their meaning, okay, their meaning is not yet completed. Okay, so that is why they are requiring a complement. Similarly, intransitive verbs also, if they require a complement, they are incomplete. If they do not require a complement, it means they are complete. Obviously, if something is complete, they do not require any further word to convey their sense. Okay? So that is why when I'm going to say verbs of complete predication, it means that they do not require any complement. And when I say verbs of incomplete predication, that it means that they require a complement. Okay? So transitive verbs which require objective complements to convey their full meaning in a sentence are called transitive verbs of incomplete predication. For example, the trophy made Ali so happy. Ali is a object. Okay. Transitive verbs of complete predication. Transitive verb which does not require a complement to convey its meaning is called transitive verb of complete predication, because their meaning is already clear. Ali threw a ball. He gave me a box of chocolates. Okay, here a box of chocolates cannot be used as a noun phrase. It can be used as a direct object. Okay. Now, students, all of you take out your books. One more picture in transitive verbs of incomplete predication. The family appears or look, but the sense is incomplete. So the family appears sad. We have put an adjective after it. Okay, to convey their full meaning. Sad is the complement of a pair, a verb of incomplete predication. Okay. Verbs of incomplete predication, idea of being, becoming, seeming, or appearing. Complement can be a noun or an adjective. Okay. When a complement describes the subject, it is called a subjective complement. As I have told you, intransitive verbs require a subjective complement. Okay? Debbie is a car. John became a soldier. Mr. Mehta became mayor. You look happy. Okay? Here is became, became, look are the intransitive verbs. Okay? A cat, noun, a soldier, noun, mayor, noun, happy, adjective. So these are the complements of the verbs is, became, and look. Okay, Vita? Now all of you have to open your books, grammar books. Okay, page page number 24. Page number 25. Okay, verbs of incomplete predication. Now I'm going to ask the definition one by one. Okay, so please, one by one, all of you have to participate. Okay. First of all, I'm going to ask. Yes, Musaf. Open your books, page number 25. Okay, page number 25. Okay, students, so I'll repeat again, all of you know this thing. That what are transitive verbs? Transitive verbs are such verbs which are followed by an object. Intransitive verbs are such verbs which do not require an object to convey their complete meaning. Okay? Now, students, you have to, yes, Musaf, what is the difference between a transitive and an intransitive verb?
Teacher, just 1 minute.
Okay.
Transitive verb shows an action which passes over from the subject to the object.
So it means that transitive verbs require an object. Okay?
Object.
What do transitive verbs require? They require an object. And intransitive verbs?
And intransitive verbs are those verbs that do not require an object to complete their action.
Good. Okay. Now, I will ask now Roma. Yes, Roma, you have to tell me what is meant by verbs of incomplete predication. You can raise your hand, anyone who wants to tell me the answer. Yes, Roma.
Teacher, can you repeat the question?
Rita, what is meant by verbs of incomplete predication? As I have explained.
Teacher, the verbs of incomplete predication are have complement.
Okay, because their meaning is not?
Not complete.
Yes, but why they do require complement? Because their meaning is not complete. Okay. Which complements are required by intransitive verbs, subjective or objective?
Subjective.
Because intransitive verbs do not have an object. Okay. And which complements are required by transitive verbs?
Objective.
Objective. Because they have an object. Okay. Now, other student will tell me, Maria Mujib. Maria Mujib, you can tell me what kind of complements? Complements can be of what type? How many types I've explained? Yes, Peter. Anyone can explain. Dabi. Peter, complements can be noun, noun phrase, adjective, adverb, clause. Okay? Now, all of you open your books, page number 25. Verbs of incomplete predication. Okay? I have explained this thing. I'm just reading it out. The complements of intransitive verbs tell us something vital. Vital means important about the subject and are therefore called subjective complements. Okay, this I have explained to you. Because intransitive verbs do not have an object. Okay, they do not have an object. So they require a subject, a complement to convey their meaning. And the complements required by intransitive verbs are called subjective complements. Okay? For example, she gave me a ball. I kicked the ball. Okay? That is, she gave me a ball. Ball is a direct object and me is the indirect object. Okay? Now, if we say we colored the fence blue, so blue is a complement. Okay? He looks puzzled. The princess later became the queen. Puzzled is an adjective required by the intransitive verb looks, and the queen is a noun required by the intransitive verb became. Okay, beta. Now, you can read transitive verbs. Okay.
Yeah.
Who will read transitive verbs? Yes, Roma, you can read.
Read the sentences. Her grandparents named her Natasha. My gift made her very, very happy. The word Natasha noun and happy adjective are required by transitive verb named and made to convey their complete sense. They are the complement of the transitive verb named and made.
As I have told you, transitive verbs require a complement which tells more about their object. So the complements required by the transitive verbs are called objective complements, and the complements required by intransitive verbs are called subjective complements. Better, this difference must be clear, that the complements which are required by intransitive are called subjective complements. And the complements which are required by transitive verbs are called objective complement. Okay? Now, we are going to turn over the page number 26. Okay? Page number 26, exercise number D. Okay?
Okay.
You have to underline the verbs in the following sentences and identify whether they are transitive or intransitive. First of all, you will underline the verb. If they have an object, write transitive. If they do not have an object, write intransitive. Then, you also have to tell which ones are verbs of incomplete predication. Like, which verbs require a complement to convey their meaning. Okay? I'm giving you 2 to 3 minutes to all of you, beta, all of you. Okay? Now, all of you have to go through this exercise. I'm giving you 2 to 3 minutes time. Okay? Then I'm going to ask you one by one, and all of you have to participate. Hasnain, you also. Everybody. Okay? Mariam, everyone.
Excuse me, teacher. Everybody.
Yes, beta.
Teacher, please take example de dengi.
Beta, it's very easy. For example, you can see the first sentence. My sister is my best friend. There is no object. There is no object in it.
Yes.
So it is. And what is the verb in this sentence? Is. Okay? So is yes. Is the verb of incomplete predication. You will underline is and you will write, because verb of incomplete predication will be too long. you can write V O I P, the first letters. V O I P means verbs of incomplete predication. Is this clear to everyone? Okay, yes. Beta, because time is short, we have to complete it. I have paid the annual school fee. In this sentence, there is the direct object because it is telling what I have paid the annual school fee. So you will underline have paid and you will write transitive. It is a transitive verb. Remember, listen. If after a verb, there is an adjective, there is an adverb, there is in the sentence or was in the sentence, then these are verbs of incomplete predication because they do not have an object. Do you understand now?
Yes.
Okay. We will do it quickly. Everybody. Yes, time is short, so we are going to do it one by one. Okay? Now first, Hasnain. Hasnain, unmute your mic, beta. Hasnain Ali, unmute your mic. One and two we have done. Do the third one. Okay, Musaf, you do. Most of you do. Beta, time is short. We have to finish it. Only 8 minutes are left. Yes, Musaf, number 3.
We feel quite worried. Teacher,
be very careful.
V is verb of incomplete prediction. Predication.
That is correct. Predication. Verb of incomplete predication. And what is the verb?
Feel.
Feel. Correct. Good, Beta. Good, Musaf. We feel quite worried because worried is an adjective. So feel, there is no direct object. So feel is the verb of incomplete predication. Okay? Yes. Number four. Number four, Khatija. Khatija, number four. Khatija, number four, Beta. Mariam Mujib. Tabeen. Beta, you have to unmute your mic, okay? If you have any problem, you can write to me, you can ask me. But you have to participate, otherwise you will not be able to learn, okay? Tabeen, can you hear me? I don't know if there's any problem with your mic. Yes, Tabeen. Tell me the fourth one.
My father seems to
Yes. And it is? What?
Verb of incomplete predication.
Good. Verb of incomplete predication because there is no object. There is no object. Number five. Yes, Khatija. Now you have to do number five. Khatija Hussain. Yes, Beta. Who will do? Musaf. Now, one by one, quickly do. Now, yes, Musaf.
Yes, can I tell?
Yes.
This one.
Yes, you can tell, Beta.
The trees have lost their leaves. Have lost is a verb and it is transitive verb.
Good. It is a transitive verb because their leaves is the direct object. Beta, I have unmuted all the students, okay? You have to click on your mic and you will be unmuted, okay? Now, number six. Why are you so upset? Who will do it? Who will do it?
mean?
Yes, Musaf.
Teacher.
How do you, why are you so upset? Very good. And it is?
R is verb of incomplete predication.
Very good. Because there is no direct object. Upset is an adjective. Also do the seventh one. Let her decide for herself.
Jahar.
Jahar is a pronoun.
Decide.
Decide. Decide. And it is a? It is a? It is simple intransitive verb. It is simple intransitive verb. Okay, students, listen to me. You have to click on your mic button, then you will be unmuted, okay? He showed me the way to the town. Quickly, quickly. He showed me the way. Showed. Good. And it is what? Transitive verb. Because what is he showing? The way. He showed me the way to the town. Good. Good, Tabi. They were on time as usual.
Were.
Were. And it is?
Transitive. Intransitive.
This is verb of incomplete predication. Okay? Remember one thing. Is, are, am, was, were are mostly verb of incomplete predication because there is no direct object after them. Okay, so they are verb of incomplete predication. Those dogs live in that street.
Live.
Live.
Live. And it is?
Intransitive.
Very good. Intransitive verb. Now just listen. If you can see, kinds of complements for intransitive verbs. Is the screen clear to you people? Can you see it? Or you can open your books. Okay? Now, better remember one thing which I have already explained to you, that intransitive verb can be followed by various kinds of words and phrases like noun, pronoun, prepositional, adverb, adverbial participle, and adjective. Okay? Because intransitive verbs do not have an... They do not have an...
Object.
What they do not have? Object. They do not have an object. So they are either completed by a noun or an adjective or a pronoun or a preposition. One example. I will read. His name is Kareem. Is the girl in the photo is not you. Okay. Over here it is using you as a compliment. My aunt is coming to dinner. To dinner. Prepositional phrase. What is a phrase? Who will tell me? What is a phrase?
So phrases do not have any meaning.
Yes.
It's a Boolean sentence.
Because phrase does not have a verb. They are a group of words. One word, sorry, two words or three words. Okay? Now, Vita, turn over to the next page. Save exercise E. Exercise E. Exercise E. Okay. This is the last page. Exercise E. Page number 27. Say what kind of complement each of the transitive verbs has in the given sentences. You have to tell if the complement is noun, adjective, adverb, prepositional phrase, or a clause. All of you know that clause is a part of a sentence which begins with a conjunction that, which, who, whom. In class 6 we did that, okay? Just quickly tell me. Number 1, Musaf. The teacher looked angry. Better than you have to finish this in homework, okay? The teacher looked angry. What is the complement? Anyone
angry?
Student can tell me. Angry. And it is an adjective. I felt that something was wrong with my computer. That something was wrong.
My computer.
That something was wrong. Better, you have to underline that something was wrong with my computer. It is a clause. The princess excelled in good governance. In good governance. It is followed by prepositional phrase. in good governance. Okay. Both Aleem and Tahir are absent. Absent. Adjective. Is that